the Skyhawk pilot inverted his aircraft and began to climb. He was unaware that Nadavi's F-15 was right above him. The inevitable collision occurred. In the unforgiving skies of the Negev Desert, on May 1st, 1983, a heart-pounding training exercise was unfolding. It was a duel of the skies, where two F-15D Eagles were tasked with defending against four aging A-4N Skyhawks in an airfield defense operation. Eagerness and tensions were high, as everyone wanted to put these fighters through their paces. Back then, the F-15 was a symbol of cutting-edge technology. Having been in service for the United States since 1976, and for Israel a year later, it had already carved out its legacy. At the controls of one of the F-15s was Zeev Nadavi, who was piloting a remarkable bird known as Falcon 957, which had achieved an impressive 4 mid-kills in the Lebanon War a year prior. Nadavi was an experienced pilot, but a new F-15 Eagle driver. He was mentored by seasoned pilot Yehor Gal, who occupied the rear seat. The skies erupted as both sides jockeyed for an advantageous position, each pilot striving for that decisive kill. Amidst the chaos, the number 3 Skyhawk identified an opportunity to strike, targeting Nadavi's wingman and the other F-15. Unbeknownst to the Skyhawk pilot, Nadavi's Baz 957 was lurking just above and behind him, ready to unleash notational missiles. When the Skyhawk pilot inverted his aircraft and began to climb in pursuit, he was unaware that Nadavi and Gal were right above him. The inevitable collision occurred. The A-4 disintegrated in a ball of flames, fortunately allowing its pilot to successfully eject. The F-15, however, was sent into a perilous downward spiral, with its nose pitched down 30 degrees, plummeting towards the earth. Nadavi struggled to regain control. Gal advised him to prepare for an ejection as soon as stability permitted. With quick thinking, Nadavi engaged the F-15's afterburner, a counterintuitive move when plummeting towards the earth. But slowly, he managed to halt the roll and point the nose upward. Not wanting to lose the aircraft, and only able to ascertain that an opaque spray of jet fuel was leaving the right wing, Nadavi decided to land the F-15. Unbeknownst to him at the time, his decision to land at Raymond Air Base, over 10 miles away, shouldn't have been possible. As they reached the runway, Nadavi attempted to reduce his speed, but doing so sent the plane back into a downward spin. So back on the afterburners went. This forced them to land at double the standard approach speed. Nadavi dropped the tail hook and caught the wire a third of the way down the strip. The hook sheared off. The ground crew quickly raised the emergency barrier to prevent the fighter still racing down the runway from going beyond it. Fortunately, Nadavi, firmly on the brakes at this point, succeeded in coming to a stop just a mere 20 feet from the runway's edge. As Nadavi popped open the canopy and turned to Gal to shake his hand, it was only then that they could finally comprehend the full extent of the damage. This F-15 had flown over 10 miles with only one wing. McDonnell Douglas, the plane's manufacturer, initially found the account hard to believe. However, after examining the aftermath firsthand, they acknowledged that due to its wide body style, given significant thrust, the aircraft could essentially function like a rocket and didn't strictly require both wings. Baz 957 underwent a comprehensive restoration process, Remarkably, it returned to active duty in 1985 and even contributed to the downing of a Syrian MiG-23. Today, this resilient aircraft has found its retirement spot in an open-air museum in Israel, where it stands as a testament to its enduring legacy. The story of the F-15 Eagle begins in the early 1970s, born out of a need for a dedicated air superiority fighter. We needed an aircraft that could contend with the ultimate Soviet boogeyman, the MiG-25 Foxbat, an aircraft that at that time was believed to outclass anything we currently possess. As brilliant minds gathered to sketch, model, and test, the objective was clear: create a fighter that was faster, more agile, and more deadly than anything before it. Were they successful? You better believe it. Irving L. Burroughs Jr. flew the first F-15 Eagle on July 27, 1972. When the F-15 first took to the skies, it was an immediate game changer. Its combination of advanced radar systems, high thrust-to-weight ratio, and unparalleled maneuverability set new benchmarks in aerial warfare. No one from its beginnings could have predicted the amount of time this plane would stay in the sky. A variation of the F-15 Eagle has now remained in service for over half a century. Not only has it remained airborne, it has also remained undefeated. 104 wins, 0 losses. The Pima Air and Space Museum, located in Tucson, Arizona, is home to an impressive collection of historic aircraft, including the F-15A Eagle. The museum's exhibit not only showcases the aircraft's exterior, but also delves into its technological innovation and operational history. Visitors can witness firsthand the sleek design that set new standards for fighter jets of its era. The F-15 Eagle stands as a testament to the remarkable ingenuity and dedication of the aerospace industry. As we reflect on its illustrious history, we are reminded of its incredible feats. Even though its journey is not yet complete, its legacy today remains unmatched. Consider checking out our video on the F-4 Phantom, the famous predecessor to the F-15.